Namashivaya, student, today I will going to start another topic from the chapter number 12, and this is the introduction from this chapter, and the chapter name is Atom, and this is part 114. So this is the chapter, and this is the first topic from the chapter, Gija and Marsden alpha particle scattering experiment. So on the suggestion of Rutherford, his two associates experiment, these are the two associates who experiment by bombarding alpha particle on a gold foil. So what is the observation? Observation is most of the alpha particle pass through the gold foil undeflected. A very small number of alpha particles suffered large angle of deflection. Some of them retracted their path or suffered 180 degree deflection. So this is the conclusion. This is the atom is hollow. An entire positive charge and nearly whole mass of atom is concentrated in a small centered nucleus of atom. So according to the Coulomb's law, it holds good for atomic distance, and negatively charged electrons are outside the nucleus. Next, impact parameter. What is the impact parameter? The perpendicular distance of initial velocity vector of alpha particle from the nucleus when the particle is far away from the nucleus is called the impact parameter. It is denoted by B for head on approach of alpha particle, B equals to 0. Angle of scattering, this is denoted by phi, and the angle of scattering of alpha particle is derived from the original deflection is called the angle of scattering. B equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught z square by ek cot phi by 2. This is the value of B. Here ek is the initial kinetic energy for head on approach of alpha particle, and impact parameter where B equals to 0. So this is the B, this is the value of the this is the value of the B. Now distance of closest approach. This is also another topic from the chapter. The similar distance which is approach of alpha particle near heavy nucleus is a measure of a size of nucleus. So here the distance of nearest approach, it is equivalent to size of nucleus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Ez e square by Ek, where Ek is the kinetic energy of the incident alpha particle and Z is the atomic number and E is the electronic charge. My next topic is Rutherford atomic model. Atom consists of central heavy nucleus containing positive charge and negatively charged electron. Now this is circulating around the nucleus, is in circular orbit. So Rutherford model could explain the neutrality of the atom, and there is a emission which is called thermionic emission in photoelectric effect, but it could not explain the stability of the atom through the observation line of the spectrum of the atom, or which we can say the atomic spectrum. This is very important topic, Bohr model. Bohr modified Rutherford model and explained the line spectrum of hydrogen. Postulate of Bohr theory. Stationary circular orbit. An atom which consists of a central positively charged nucleus and negatively charged electrons revolve around the nucleus in certain orbit called stationary orbit. The electrostatic Coulomb's force between electrons and the nucleus, which provides the necessarily centripetal force. Here m v square by r equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught z e by r square, where z is the atomic number, m is the mass of the electron, and r is the radius of the r orbit. This is the r, radius of the orbit, m is the mass, and this is the velocity, where this is v. Quantum condition. The stationary orbit are those in the angular momentum of an electron is an integral multiple by of h by 2 pi, or this mvr equals to nh by 2 pi, where n equals to 1, 2, 3. This is the value of n is called the principal quantum number. The equation is called Bohr quantum condition. This is the Bohr quantum condition. Transition. The electron does not radiate energy when in a stationary, when it is present in a stationary orbit. The quantum of energy is emitted or absorbed when an electron jumps from one stationary orbit to another stationary orbit, and the frequency of the emitted or absorbed photon is given by h nu equals to e that ei minus ef. This is the this is called the Bohr frequency condition. This is all about equations, but we will going to learn derivation later. This is the introduction from the chapter. Radius of orbit and energy of electron in orbit. So there is a conditions of motions of electron in a circular orbit, mv square by r equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon or zee by r square. So there is a condition which is Bohr quantum condition, which is equivalent to mvr equals to nh by 2 pi, where v equals to nh by 2 pi mr. Substituting the value of this equation, this is the v, the value on the first equation, this is the v, and we have to substitute that value on here. So we are putting the value here, so it is equivalent to m by r nh by 2 pi mr, that whole square equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught z e square by r square. And so here r equals to epsilon naught n square h square n square by 4 by pi m z is square. So there is a denoting of radius, which is nth orbit. This is equivalent to r nth equals to epsilon naught h square n square by pi m z is square, where the electron, where the hydrogen atom, where z equals to 1. So r n, that whole h, equals to epsilon naught h square n square by pi m e square. So this is the value, the radius of the orbit, first orbit of hydrogen of an atom. This is called Bohr's radius. It is denoted by a naught. It is equivalent to epsilon naught a square by pi m e square. It is equivalent to 0.529 that angstrom degree. This is the value of epsilon naught. Energy of an orbiting electron. This is also a very, very important topic. Mv square equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught equals to 1 by equals to into z e square by r. So kinetic energy k equals to half mv square equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught z e square by 2r. There is a potential energy which is equivalent to E equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught z minus z e square by r, and it is minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught z e square by r. We are putting the values. We are only putting the values, and we are splitting this value z e squared, that means z e into e divided by r. Now this is the kinetic energy, and this is the potential energy, and this is the equation. Now what is the total energy? Kinetic energy plus potential energy. This is the kinetic energy and this is the potential energy. So we are putting the values here, e squared, that means e into e, and this is the negative e, so that's why it is negative. Because we know that plus and minus equivalent to minus. Now we are doing the equations where E equals to minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon or z square by 2r. This is the nth orbit, and this is writing En for E. So we are substituting the value, which is equivalent to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught z square by 2rn. And rn is the substituting the value. So we are substituting the value of rn, which is equivalent to epsilon naught a square n square by 4 pi by pi m z square. So after calculating the equation, after calculating the value, it is equivalent to minus mz square square into 8 epsilon naught square a square into a square. This is the very, very important derivation we will do later. Now there is a constant which is called Rydberg constant, which is r equals to m e to the power 4 8 epsilon naught square ch cube. So we are putting so this is the value of r. So here there is a constant which is called Rydberg constant, 1.97 into 10 to the power minus 1 minus 1 per meter. So yeah, the value of En equals to z minus z square r h c divided by n square. So means we are substituting the Rydberg constant over there, means the value of E. So means the value of total energy. Now so the energy of an orbiting electron in h atom, it is equivalent to minus r h c divided by n square, and En equals to minus 13.6 n square by eV into eV. So this indicates that the radii of and energies of hydrogen like atoms are quantized. This is the energy of orbiting electron in h atom, hydrogen atom. So this is important topic, you know that Bohr's theory and Bohr's postulate and the total energy. So this is all about my today's topic. Tomorrow I will going to start another topic from the chapter. So thank you, student, for watching this video.